I gotta pick a game. I have to pick something. Tomb Raider, no. Kingdom Hearts, Chain of Memories. Someday, my precious. Someday. Maybe one of the PSP games. Tag Force. That'd be pretty cool. No, not today. Not today, no. Unfortunately, throughout all these wonderful games, I've still got Kingdom Hearts in the back burner. Yeah, it's on the burner. So, I decided, whilst I'm waiting to do that, what would be good? Well, simple. All these games must have had a trailer at one point. Concept that it sparked us to kind of go, here's our money, give us the game. Overall, I'm going to talk about the five top trailers that caught my eye that went, have my money, I don't care, just take it and give me the game. So, we're going to start off pretty simple. Let's see what the top one is. But before we do that, I'm going to suggest some rules on this one. Rule one, it's my list. If you don't like it, just don't be nasty about it and just respect that fact. It's my choice. It's not a definitive list anywhere. It's not the top five ultimate trailers. This is ones that have caught my attention. And if you have any ones that you like, please talk about them. Rule two, one per franchise. I'm not going to fill this with Metal Gear trailers because every single one of them is great. Doesn't matter if it's Metal Gear 4, Metal Gear 3, Metal Gear 2, Acid, or any of the other ones like Gaiden. Or, is that what they called the Game Boy one? Ah, who cares. And last rule. Each one has to be meeting a criteria, effectively. I'm not doing five top shooter trailers. I'm not doing five fighter trailers. I'm doing five trailers that have caught my eye. If you want me to do a fighter's trailers or something like that, please tell me, because I'll actually do it. Meanwhile, I'm going to go pick a game. I haven't played Tomb Raider 2 in a while. You guys are going to watch my list. Have fun. Now, I'm not known to play Call of Duty for its multiplayer, but I do like its story when there is actually one. This one, Call of Duty Advanced Warfare, stood out with an A-list group with Kevin Spacey heading it, Troy Baker leading as the main protagonist, and quite a diverse cast with an amazing plot due to the fact of Advanced War being one of the biggest things to focus on with a private military. The trailer alone is able to suck me in and make me feel compelled to want to see how this all unfolded due to the fact it's very quick flashing imagery, seeing new characters, new places, conflict, and then Kevin Spacey just speaking about a future war and being a private military, not having to get involved with political instances, such as other games as the Modern Warfare series is able to do with political being America versus Russia or some form of that. This one just put it simply as Kevin Spacey versus the world. That's worth the ticket price to sit down and play this game, and the trailer was enough for me to be sucked in and want to find out more. Marvel's Spider-Man is by far the best version of a Spider-Man game we're going to get. There were very close ones in the past on the PlayStation or the PlayStation 2 which came very close to feeling like playing the Spider-Man. There were some horrible ones in the PlayStation 3, and now since we've got a proper Spider-Man game, there had been a brilliant trailer to push this due to the fact that with its popularity with the movies and with the idea of wanting a free-roaming open adventure Spider-Man game that's going to suck us in with a great story, the cinematic had to be perfect. And watching this cinematic here shows the fact of not only will we be fighting very nostalgic villains, but there's going to be an original plot using Mr. Negative. That is a B-list villain, but holy god, the story was compelling enough for me to actually want to go and play this game too. The cinematic is just a work of art on itself due to the fact it shows personal demons and actually inner conflict within itself. So this actually set up for such a dark but very mysterious plotline for me. So it's well worth the look into if you really want to play a good Spider-Man game, really.
Another series I'm a big fan of is the Fallout series. And with this trailer being announced years ago for Fallout 4, I was very excited due to the fact that not only did you see when the atomic bombs fell and have to witness this, but you were also waking up years later with a massive problem of your son going missing and the world being at each other's throat, whether it was about the synths, the Underground Railroad, the Brotherhood of Steel, or anything else. It just showed a world in turmoil, and the fact that you as a player have that choice influence one of the outcomes. Due to the fact Fallout is actually very popular for multiple endings or multiple choice routes to actually benefit the player. Sure, later on DLC came out which progressed some of those choices and even gave you a different outcome for your future. This was enough for me to kind of go, oh yeah, this is well worth the ticket. It's not often I get invested in BioWare games. Now, it's true that I do like games that are RPG based, but when I started playing Mass Effect 3 when I was back in uni, I decided that I would actually follow this through. Playing all the DLCs and even managing to complete number 1 and 2 in its entirety where there's nothing left, I was eager, I was willing and wanting the third one to come out and feel like a wrap up to the series. I wanted to feel like the biggest, baddest threat had landed on my doorstep, that there was a bleak game awaiting for me, with a possible good ending, or a very bad outcome, which we all knew was going to be. Mass Effect 3 lands this in its trailer. It shows the fact that the poop has hit the fan in such a spectacular way, that hope is not a thing, but you as Commander Shepard has to find a way through the Reaper threat. And this was enough for me to eagerly pre-order the game, get the special DLC stuff, and complete the game in its entirety, waiting for the DLC as well. Due to the fact, yes, super fan, but also the fact that this game can show cinematic features of a sci-fi film, which can compel via characters and make you feel that you are standing against an overwhelming threat that you can't fight. Mass Effect 3 was definitely in my top picks for this.
So even though you've probably gone, the top 5 to 2 are pretty gaff, or you're actually going, wow, some of these trailers are really good and I can't believe I completely missed them. Bet you're not going to be expecting what my top 1 is. And trust me, when making this list, I found this hard to sort of choose between quite a few. Now, I've got a few honorable mentions, which I will be doing quickly. However, the top one, yeah, I think you guys are going to be quite surprised that even I picked this one.
James, honey, did something happen to you? After we got separated in that long hallway?
Now, to say I'm a huge Metal Gear fan is an understatement. I've actually completed every single Metal Gear out there, including Survive. That wasn't a good choice on my behalf. Overall, there's always one trailer that stuck in my head so much, and that was the Metal Gear Solid 2 Sons of Liberty trailer. I first saw this trailer on a PS2 demo disc for when it first was announced. The trailer opens up just to the vocally sung version of Can't Say Goodbye to Yesterday, while showing off the location which we are going to be based upon, which is an oil rig, or the Big Shell, which was later found out in the game. After the song concludes, it then kicks into the actual trailer of showing, not only showing Snake, but showing the variety of characters, whether it's Olga, Revolver Ocelot, Fortune, Vamp, Hal, or any other character. It shows them in glimpses and quotes that are out of order or out of sequence that give the trailer a wee bit more context or misleading context. This is down to the fact Hideo Kojima is brilliant at direction and misleading people within his own creations. Just look at Death Stranding or any of the Metal Gear series. I remember because I was that young and I had to ask my mum and dad to buy me this game because I was that hyped for it. Due to the fact I had played the original Metal Gear Solid on the PlayStation 1 backwards, forwards, knew all the secrets, all the codec calls, and could pretty much recite half the game off by heart, I was eager to find out how Solid Snake would continue his mission against the Metal Gears, or how he'd find the Patriots, or what he was going to do next in order to bring down any form of the Patriot system. Well, with this trailer, it shows you that things are a lot more bigger than just Shadow Moses. And it was very misleading for what we got. And I cannot praise the game more for a trailer that hypes me up, still hits me on my nostalgia button, but also gets me super happy to play the HD version.
So there you have it, people. 5 top trailers I have enjoyed. 5 top trailers I've liked that made me go out and get the games, or at least preview them and play them enough that I've either enjoyed or disliked them. But due to the fact it's the trailers I'm more talking about, and I've hoped you've enjoyed these trailers as much as I have enjoyed showing them off, and that's why they're in my top 5. Am I looking forward to more trailers over time? Yeah, sure, there's gonna be some really good trailers. Like, I wanted to put Doom Eternal in it, but that's not really a trailer, it's kind of gameplay footage slash trailer, and it's weird when that happens. That's why they weren't included, those kind of things. I do hope you enjoy this, and yes, I will be doing Kingdom Hearts 3 as the next video. This isn't another main series, this is actually a top 5, and I'm going to be doing quite a lot of these top 5, top 10. Hope you've enjoyed this. Once again, subscribe, like, and tell me what your favourite trailers were, because quite a few of them I've either skipped over, completely forgot, or there's quite hundreds of them out there that I would actually like to look over and go, wow, might pick up that game. So, let me know, people. Until next time, who knows, it might actually be Kingdom Hearts 3. Thank you very much, people, for watching. I am so sorry this is not Kingdom Hearts 3. If you follow my Facebook page, you'll understand why I don't actually have Kingdom Hearts 3 uploaded today, or I'm in the process of redoing it again and again and again. The whole entire explanation I will quickly say now is because I recently had to move my recording space once again, as you see, brand new setup once again. This is the definite for a while until we move or whatever happens with my life. This is kind of the permanent setup I'm looking to do. Video games planned, hopefully related at one point. Just now I'm G-Man Art. Awesome. The whole reason is because my record space, which was over the other side of the room, is completely blacked out because I had to make a giant monolith of a wardrobe. That's why. I was also very exhausted, came down with flu at the same time, and was very sick. The video footage I had captured, it kind of did half the video and then the other half didn't record. So that's also another reason I haven't really got back to it. I just went strike and right back to it. The audio wasn't particularly happy with, because I'm still trying not to be nervous. I'm still trying to be very good with these videos. I do hope, like, you're sitting with me going, well, you know, we're seeing you're trying. Enough of the excuses. The next video is Kingdom Hearts 3. I'm trying some different things, trying to be a wee bit of my own self instead of copying certain YouTubers. I hope you have enjoyed this video, and I'm sorry it's taken a wee while to get another mainstream video out. I will figure out a proper recording angle and all sorts, so you never know. Once again, thank you very much. If you've liked my video, please subscribe and like. This is a very lengthy subscribe title card at the end. I'm so sorry. So thank you very much, and catch you around for the next video. Memory card.